In this video, I wanted to talk about ways of feeling more confident and more useful in a world that's ever-changing and sometimes uncertain. As I have a lot of exposure to getting things happening in the area of autism, I find that in a lot of the younger people, especially the younger men in particular, that oftentimes the world can seem a very uncertain place. And this can mean uncertainty with employment, also stress with study, also a feeling of despair at times, and also a feeling of low self-confidence and motivation. I can only give you my advice in relation to these issues, but the first thing I would suggest to anyone, particularly to the younger people, is have a LinkedIn profile, and on that LinkedIn profile, treat it as an online resume. Because when I use LinkedIn myself, I often look at other people's LinkedIn profiles. And the thing that stands out is writing a summary about yourself, a summary that describes who you are and what you are wanting or what your interests are as a person. I also look for a profile photo that indicates a professional sort of image of someone, and this may mean, you know, just wearing a tie or a sports coat or a suit or whatever. And I also look at the actual endorsements and the area of expertise that exist in the many profiles that I see on LinkedIn. And I think that it's a good way to network and a good way to communicate. But more importantly, we need to get back to the grassroots challenges and hardcore issues and challenges that are confronting many young people today. And these are the feelings of uncertainty and not having employment, etc. I think it's important to maintain a healthy headspace. And this means to have regular exercise, eat healthy food, and also have friendships and create new friendships. Often people push other people away, and this creates a feeling of isolation and abandonment. At times of despair and frustration, maintaining a healthy mind is important, and also ensuring you have friendships and social interaction. The challenges I confront at the moment are dealing with some difficulty in my own life, even though I have some plans, and that is mainly when a parent is in hospital with depression and anxiety, it can often make it very, very difficult to be able to know what to do to maintain your own sense of well-being and functioning ability. It's not like the analogy with being on an airplane, that when the first thing to do is to put on your own oxygen mask before you can put an oxygen mask on someone else. So my core advice to young people is to update your LinkedIn profile regularly, to also exercise regularly where you can. This may include some cardiovascular activity, bike riding, even some gym work. It doesn't mean you have to be like Arnold Schwarzenegger. It just means you have to have a self-discipline to be able to lift weights just to keep your bone structure and your muscle tone under control, etc. The other thing is also to have friends to do things with on weekends. And don't turn people away that may be seeking friendship, because we are social creatures, and to have a healthy mind, we do need to have interaction with other people and healthy interaction at that. The other thing also is for students that are in the tertiary environment, the main thing is to balance study with also pleasure and also meaningful pursuits. This might include going on a trip somewhere. Maybe it might be saving up to go to Nepal. Might be wanting to go on a the Milford soundtrack or something like that, just to have something in life that gives your life a purpose and something to look forward to. To also start planning and mapping out the future scenario of where you want to be and where you want to go. I also would encourage students or young people, if you don't spend money, to save it, to invest it, to put into a term deposit, to make the most of it, start looking at a retirement plan, start looking at your own financial position and asking yourself, where do you want that to be in 10 or 20 years' time? It's very difficult in life to be able to know exactly where things are going, but the only way you can get forward and can get ahead and is to plan, is to do the best you can in the meantime and to not waste time and to make the most of time in a productive sense. So in this video, I do hope that I can inspire other people to perhaps take on the advice that I'm offering in this video and to be able to empower yourself with your own sense of self-discipline and motivation, because it has to come from you. It can't come from anyone else. It has to come from you first and foremost. You have to make the most of your life so that you can go forth in a positive and assertive direction. So thanks very much for watching this video.